Morning, everyone. This video is called The Woman. It is narrated and illustrated by Llama Arts. I haven't done one by them in a while, so I thought I would go ahead and do this. It popped up in my feed fairly recently, and I've seen a lot of other channels react to it, so I'm guessing it's probably pretty damn good. So hopefully it is. Let's get to watching.
It was a late, moonless, snowy night. I heard the chilling cry of a bobcat as I arrived home from my parents' house, where we had just had Thanksgiving dinner in northern Michigan. Exhausted, I had finally made it to my bed when my pregnant girlfriend asked for nacho cheese munchies. Reluctantly, I laced up my boots and went to my car. Due to the cold, it took me a while to start the car, which only made me more irritated. But eventually, I got it started,
and
I arrived
at
the convenience store to retrieve my girlfriend's mandated snacks. As I left the store, walking back towards my car, I saw a shadow of movement out of the corner of my eye. What looked like a person stood near the dumpster, just out of the light. I stepped towards the figure, and she looked at me with a giant, sinister smile. Her face was so weathered, it looked like she had cracks all over her face. She was crouched down and appeared to be chewing on something. I looked to see what she was chewing on. To my surprise, it was a severed arm. It looked old, as if it had been rotting for weeks. I saw her glance at something in her pocket. I could see the outline of what looked like a pocket knife. As soon as I looked back up, she quickly charged me. I pushed her away and then ran back to the convenience store. I burst through the door and frantically yelled towards the cashier to call the police as I turned to lock it. He asked me, "What's going on?" I scowled at him and said, "Please, just call the cops." I looked back outside and saw the woman had moved across the street and was still scrutinizing me as she maintained her malevolent grin. "Look, there's a girl out there who's trying to kill me." Looking over me, he replied, "I don't see anyone out there, sir." Those words shook me, even to this day. When the police reached the gas station, they began looking around for the woman while one of the officers asked me what had happened, and I told him the details of the encounter. One of the officers came back and said he couldn't find anything. I then took them back to where I first noticed her. We spent a few minutes intently searching, but there was no proof she was ever even there. The officer cocked his head and looked at me as if I was deranged and asked me in a judgmental tone, "Are you feeling okay?" I was about to defend myself, and then I started to think. I am tired, and I have had a couple of drinks, so I just told him, "Yes, sir. Sorry for bothering you. I hope you have a nice night." And then I drove home. I got home at around 4 o'clock in the morning. My girlfriend greeted me with an angered but concerning tone of voice. She asked me,
"Where were you? Are you okay?"
So I told her everything that happened. Of course, she didn't believe me. I couldn't get to sleep that night. I sat in my bed questioning my sanity, wondering if it was all even real. Am I crazy?
Oh my gosh.
Maybe I'm just tired. But no, that can't be it. I saw it. But if I saw it, why was there no proof?
Man, unless you're on some like serious type of drugs, I mean, that shit had to be fucking real. I mean, hypothetical, we're saying, obviously. If you saw something like that, I mean, I would think it was real. I don't know.
Where did the arm go? Where did she go?
Right, where's the arm? Where's
Before
the blood?
I knew it, it was 7 in the morning, and I had to go to work. I threw on my jacket as I was about to head to the construction site, and I put my hand in my pocket and noticed that there was a hole in it. It wasn't there the other day. I thought, what if she caught my jacket as I ran? Which further proves my suspicion that she was real. I couldn't believe it. My mind completely went wild until my girlfriend kissed me goodbye. I told my friends at work what had happened, and they didn't believe me either. They made jokes about it the entire day. But I had my bowling tournament that day, so that gave me something to look forward to. I got home and hung my vest and jacket up and rapidly put on my bowling shoes and got my bowling ball. My girlfriend looked at me with a pleasant smile and said,
"When will you be back?"
"Probably around 11.
Don't be long.
I won't. Don't worry. At around 10:30, the tournament had finally finished and we had won. I was so thrilled I had forgotten about the woman. As we were leaving, I noticed something at the other end of the parking lot. It was that psychotic woman. We stared at each other for what felt like an eternity. She slowly started moving towards me while waving her knife in the air and making cuts. I quickly jumped into my car and turned it on. As I looked up, I saw she was standing in front of me, staring at me. She slowly walked over to my window, and she said in a quiet, deep, and scratchy voice,
little pig, let me in.
I was frozen in fear, but I snapped back to reality when she banged on the roof of my car, screaming. I quickly slammed my foot on the accelerator and didn't let off it until I couldn't see her anymore. When I arrived home, I told my girlfriend what had happened. Like last time, she didn't believe me. I really thought I was insane, but I tried to forget about it and get some sleep. Later that night, I woke up and saw her in my room. All she said was, "Let me in," over and over. As she got closer, she then started shouting,
Let me in! Let me in! Come on, Paul. Stop being difficult.
Let me in!
I was wondering how in the world my girlfriend hadn't heard this going on. The woman was right next to me and held up a knife to me. That's when I fainted. I woke startled in my room, dripping with sweat. Then I remembered I don't have a girlfriend, nor a house, or a family.
Come on, Paul. It's time for your morning meds. Let me in.
Down 5 out of 5. You're like number one, the best fucking thing I've seen to date of Llama Arts. Wow. Plot twist. Holy shit. Oh man, that was so good. Wow, that was so good. Llama Arts, you never let me down, man. Keep up with the amazing work. Wow. That's all I can say. Wow. That was so good. Oh my god. All right. I'm going to go ahead and try and find some more. I doubt I'll find anything that I'm going to watch today that lives up to this one. But, here's the hoping. Love you all. God bless.